Hey, what's up? My name is Kiko Pinholster, and this is my producer podcast for Advanced Session Recording. I chose record producer and session guitar player Dann Huff as my producer because he found his passion at a young age, and he followed his dreams. His dad introduced him to life at the studio when he was 13. His dad would hire session guitarists, and little young Dann was in the studio one day. And John Darnall was there, and John took it upon himself to teach Dann a scale, and Dann was like, this is sweet, I want to do this. So for the next 7 years, Dann hit the ground running. He was in a high school band. Growing up in Nashville, I mean, the music was everywhere. He started up another band in his 20s called Whiteheart. And that was a little bit more well known. They were throwing some small shows and kind of getting some traction. And so they were like, you know what? Let's move out to LA. He moved out to LA when he was 21, 22 to pursue being a session guitarist at first. After about 5 or 6 years, Dann got bored in LA. He started another band with his brother. His brother's name was David, and they called the band Giant. And they moved back to Nashville in 1990 with intentions of being rock stars, full-blown rock stars, touring, shows, everything. Dann said he made some good music with Giant. He doesn't necessarily regret it, but Giant ended up falling through. He was telling a story about how he was in Sony Studios in New York, and they were mixing their second record as Giant, and someone showed him a video of Even Flow by Pearl Jam. And the lead singer, Eddie Vedder, was climbing the theater wall. I mean, like, there are countless comp videos of Eddie Vedder, hanging from lighting fixtures and rafters on the ceiling, just fearless, 30 feet up, falling off the theater walls into the crowd, 10, 15 feet, 20 feet. Like there are monkey bars. And this made Dann kind of rethink his how grungy he was. And I mean, it takes a lot to sit down with yourself and be like, I don't fit in. What else can I do to, you know, to be happy and to still work in music? And it was like this brigade of anarchists and deadheads came out of the shadows. And the same thing happened in 2016 and 2017 in my generation too. It was just out of nowhere. And it was just, I personally remember it being absolutely everywhere I went, you know, Walmart, everywhere. And then it slowly evolved into this new two-track and immersive, like, cyber street punk style of music. And now that's starting to decline in the industry and almost trying to revert back to a simpler time. But it's like, why backtrack? Just about every upcoming engineer out there, and at least from my class, including myself, we all make our own music. And it's like we said to ourselves, the best way around is right through. And I relate to Dann Huff a lot. I mean, he one of his dreams kind of died of being a lead singer, and he still found a way to chase his passion with that benefited everybody. And now look at him. He plays live with everyone he wanted to, but he plays with them from the source, from where it happens. He played with Mariah Carey, Barbara Streisand, Reba McEntire, set me free, why don't you, baby? Rod Stewart. The list of this man's credits is from 1976, and he averaged 20 to 40 projects a year. I mean, he worked with a lot more people than he probably ever would have if he stayed in the touring business. By researching Dann, you know, I've always kind of grown up with the mindset of, you know, if you follow in somebody's footsteps right behind them, you're never going to pass them. You're never going to, you know, you always got to race with people that are faster than you, to get better. And I feel like that's what Dann did.